Hello dear students, I am Professor Dheeraj Kumar Singh from Department of Mechanical Engineering, Sagar Group of Institutions, Sistekar, Bhopal. Dear students, today we are going to discuss dryness fraction, subcooled region, superheated region and wet region under the subject thermodynamics. So let's start the class. What is subcooled or undercooled region? It is a region in which the actual temperature is less than saturation temperature corresponding to that pressure. Here we have drawn TS plane and we have drawn this dome or these saturated liquid line and saturated vapor line curve for water. So here we can see this is our constant pressure line. This is our constant pressure line. And under this wet region, this is our constant pressure and constant temperature line. And left to the saturated liquid line, this is our subcooled region. So this is our subcooled region. So in this subcooled region, this saturation temperature is greater than this actual temperature on a single pressure line. On this line also we can see this is constant pressure line and this is our saturation temperature. Saturation temperature is the temperature in which our phase change process take place, right? So this T saturation is greater than T actual. So the temperature at which liquid converts into vapor, that particular temperature is known as our saturation temperature. The temperature at which liquid converts into vapor or vapor converts into liquid. So degree of subcooling is T saturation minus T actual. T saturation is saturation temperature, T actual is actual temperature. So here our degree of subcooling will be T saturation minus T actual, as T saturation is greater than T actual in this subcooled region. Subcooled region is a complete liquid region. Now we will move to superheated region. Superheated region is our complete vapor region. This region is our superheated region. So it is a region in which the actual temperature is greater than saturation temperature corresponding to that pressure. So this is constant pressure line, here we can see, and this is our saturation temperature. But in superheated region, this point, this if you will consider this particular region, then we can see this actual temperature is greater than this saturation temperature. So degree of superheat is equal to T actual minus T saturation. T actual will be more and T saturation will be less. So degree of superheat will be T actual minus T saturation in this superheated region. Now we will move to wet region. What is wet region? It is a region in which liquid and vapor exists in equilibrium. Whenever the fluid is in wet region, it will be at its saturation temperature. So here we can see in this TS diagram, this region inside this dome is known as our wet region, where liquid and vapor both coexist, right? So both will be there, liquid and vapor, because this is our saturated liquid line. Left to that line, this is subcooled region where complete liquid we will get, and this is our wet region where liquid and vapor we will get, and this is saturated vapor line. Right to this saturated vapor line we will get superheated region, right? So here we can see in this box that here it is liquid. So this point is complete liquid point and this point is complete vapor point. Right. So in wet region, our saturation temperature and saturation pressure will pressure lines are coincide. Right. So here we can see this is subcooled region, this is wet region, and this is superheated region, and this point is our critical point where saturated liquid line and saturated vapor line curve meets. So in two phase region, constant pressure and constant temperature lines coincide. Here we can see this thing. What is latent heat? It is the amount of heat required to cause phase change. As phase change occurs at constant pressure, latent heat is equal to heat transfer during phase change at constant pressure. So here we can see, dear students, that this is our TH diagram. T is temperature, H is specific enthalpy, and if we will see this straight line starting from 1 and the final state is 0.2, so this line is our phase change line. Means at point 1 we will be having complete liquid and at point 2 we will be having complete vapor. So what is latent heat? Latent heat is the amount of heat, this is Q, required to cause phase change, and that will be equal to the heat transfer during phase change at constant pressure. So H2 minus H1 will be our latent heat. So here latent heat is equal to del Q P means heat transfer at constant pressure is equal to change in enthalpy. So latent heat is equal to hg minus hf. G stands for saturated liquid line, or sorry, saturated vapor line. This is vapor line. So G stands for saturated vapor line, and F stands for saturated liquid line, right? So H is specific enthalpy in kilojoule per kilogram. So here Hg is enthalpy of saturated vapor and Hf is enthalpy of saturated liquid. So at critical point, we can see latent heat will be zero, because these both point 1 and 2 will coincide at point 1. Means the value of H1 and H2 will be same at critical point. So difference is zero. So that's why at critical point latent heat is zero. So as we will increase the pressure, the latent heat of vaporization value will decrease, and at critical point this value will become zero. So here also in note we have written that with increase in pressure, latent heat of vaporization decreases, and at critical point latent heat of vaporization is zero. Now dear students, we will move to dryness fraction. What is dryness fraction? Dryness fraction is also known as quality. So it is the ratio of mass of vapor to the total mass, that is liquid and vapor. So basically we are eager to find dryness fraction under the wet region, right? Under the wet region where both liquid and vapor exist. So if in 1 kilogram of liquid vapor mixture, if x kilogram is the mass of vapor and 1 minus x kilogram is the mass of liquid, then x is known as the quality or dryness fraction of the liquid vapor mixture. That means we are focusing here for vapor. So therefore quality indicates the mass fraction of vapor in a liquid vapor mixture, right? So basically we are considering here mass fraction of vapor in that liquid vapor mixture. So that is our dryness fraction. So in formula we can write x is denoted, dryness fraction is denoted as x, and the formula is mv divided by mass of vapor plus mass of liquid. So where mv is mass of vapor and ml is our mass of liquid in the mixture. Now here we can see the value of x varies between 0 to 1. Here we can see, dear students, the value of x will vary from 0 to 1. So the value of dryness fraction on saturated liquid line will be 0, and on saturated vapor line it will be 1. How this will be 0 and 1, we will understand it very soon. So for saturated water, when water just starts boiling, x equal to 0, and for saturated vapor, when vaporization is complete, x equal to 1, for which the vapor is said to be dry saturated. So dear students, we all know that this is our saturated liquid line, right? So here we will be having complete liquid, right? So if we want to put these things in the formula, x equal to mv by mv plus ml, so what will be the value of mv, mass of vapor on saturated liquid line? There is no vapor, so the mass of vapor will become zero, so automatically the dryness fraction value will become zero. And if we see on this saturated vapor line, right, so here we can see the mass of vapor, here it is saturated vapor line, that means complete vapor will be there. So the mass of vapor will be here, mass of vapor will be here, mv, right? Whatever be the mass of vapor, that will be mv. And what is the mass of liquid here? There will be no mass of liquid, right? Because it is saturated vapor. So this term ml will become zero. So mv divided by mv will get cancelled and it will become one. So dryness fraction at a saturated vapor curve will be equal to one. So constant dryness fraction lines converge at critical point. Yes, it is correct that this is constant, dryness fraction lines here I have shown on this TH plane. So you can see the dryness, this curve, that saturated liquid line curve, dryness fraction x equal to 0 here. Then again, if we'll go left to right, then dryness fraction value will increase. So that increase means the value, the content of vapor, the mass of vapor will increase. So x equal to 0.1, here x equal to 0.2. As we will go from left to right, the value of dryness fraction will increase. X equal to 0.8, here x equal to 0.9. And in last, this is on saturated vapor line, the value of dryness fraction x equal to 1. So this point is known as critical point, and constant dryness fraction lines converge at critical point. We can see here very easily. Reynolds fraction equal x equal to 0 along saturated liquid line. Yes, Reynolds fraction x equal to 1 along saturated vapor curve. So dear students, we can understand here Reynolds fraction very easily, that a Reynolds fraction of for saturated liquid line will be 0 and saturated vapor line will be 1, and the formula of Reynolds fraction is mass of vapor divided by the mass of vapor plus mass of liquid, that means total mass of the mixture. So that's all for today's class, dear students. Thank you.